In the comments section, I have seen many of you guys talk about DEI, the idea that some employers are hiring based off of diversity and inclusion and not purely merit. Probably the same kind of people who were talking about affirmative action when that was the describing word for what was going on for hiring people, or at least interviewing people, just to have a little bit more inclusion in the workplace as opposed to everyone who basically looks the same. So I decided to look a little bit more into what was going on to see if I could find any stories of what was happening, to see if anyone thought that this was an issue and actually did anything about it. And I actually found a story. And this story is about somebody who filed a lawsuit, and it's actually gone all the way up to the Supreme Court, claiming discrimination for being straight and white. So let's dive in. The first article I found was on shrm.org. And as always, I'll link this article down in the description below so you can read the whole thing for yourself. I'm just going to talk about the highlights and how it pertains to what we're talking about today. The headline is Supreme Court to Review White Straight Workers' Bias Claims. And it's from October 8th, 2024. And the article says, the U.S. Supreme Court has agreed to decide whether white straight workers must clear a higher bar when they are trying to prove race and sex discrimination in violation of Title VII of the Civil Rights Act of 1964. We've gathered articles on the news from SHRM and other outlets. The justices took up an appeal by Marlene Ames, a heterosexual woman who is seeking to revive her lawsuit against the Ohio Department of Youth Services, in which she said she lost her job to a gay man and was passed over for a promotion in favor of a lesbian woman in violation of federal civil rights laws. The 6th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals decided that Ames had not shown the background circumstances that courts require to prove that she faced discrimination because she is straight. At least 4 other U.S. appeals courts have adopted similar hurdles to providing discrimination claims against members of majority groups. Those courts have said the higher bar is justified because discrimination against those workers is relatively uncommon. But other courts have said that Title VII does not distinguish between biases against members of minority and majority groups. The lawsuit alleges that Ames applied for and was passed over by the department's Bureau Chief of Quality position. Following the rejection, her supervisor allegedly congratulated Ames on 30 years of public service, but also suggested Ames retire. 4 days later, Ames was allegedly fired from her job as administrator of the Prison, word I can't say on YouTube, Elimination Act, and was asked to return to a lower level position that she had previously held. Ames took the demotion and her wages were significantly reduced. Ames maintained that it was unfair to require a majority group plaintiff to show additional circumstances not asked of other plaintiffs who sue under Title VII. Ames failed to produce a pattern of similar discrimination or any proof that employment decisions were made by members of the gay community, the 6th Circuit ruled. The state of Ohio maintained that Ames was difficult to work with and that the Ohio Department of Youth Services had non-discriminatory reasons for picking another candidate and removing Ames from her position. Discriminatory preference for any group, minority or majority, is precisely and only what Congress has prescribed, Ames' lawyer wrote, quoting from the 1971 Supreme Court decision Griggs versus Duke Power. Imposing a background circumstances requirement on majority group plaintiffs, as 5 courts of appeals have done, defies these fundamental principles. Title VII shields workers from discrimination based on sexual orientation and gender identity, according to a landmark Supreme Court ruling in 2020. As individuals' homosexuality or transgender status is not relevant to employment decisions, wrote the court, that's because it is impossible to discriminate against a person for being homosexual or transgender without discriminating against the individual based on sex. So that is quite a bold move. Definitely let me know what you guys think so far down in the comments below. I mean, personally so far, I think when it comes to hiring decisions, I mean, there's definitely clicks for people to get promoted over other people. People tend to create groups and of things that they identify with, and then just hire and promote people based on the similar groups. So if people are from originally another country, or they went to the same alma mater, or different things of that nature, they might be more likely to do that. And when it comes to hiring, I mean, really the only public confession of this thing happening and public thing that I've seen so far is in the NFL, where they have this rule where for every head coaching opening, you have to interview at least one, I don't know if it's African-American or a person of color, but they seem to just go and interview people of color. And I don't know if that really determines whether they're going to hire that person or not. I don't know if they give that person a fair shake, or if they just go through the motions to say that they did it. So you could put laws and restrictions in place, even when it comes to interviewing. It's just a matter of, do I have to hire people to diversify things a little bit, or do I just have to give them a fair interview opportunity? Don't really know. Our second article is from Reuters, and the headline is, U.S. Supreme Court to decide if white straight workers face higher bar in bias lawsuits. The U.S. Supreme Court agreed on Friday to decide whether it should be more difficult for workers from majority backgrounds, such as white or heterosexual people, to prove workplace discrimination claims. The justices took up an appeal by Marlene Ames, a heterosexual woman, seeking to revive her lawsuit against the Ohio Department of Youth Services, in which she lost her job to a gay man and was passed over for a promotion in favor of a gay woman in violation of federal civil rights laws. Since the 1980s, at least four other U.S. appeals courts have adopted similar hurdles to proving discrimination claims against members of majority groups, largely in cases involving white men. Those courts have said the higher bar is justified because discrimination against those workers is relatively uncommon. But other courts have said that Title VII does not distinguish between the bias against majority and minority groups. A Supreme Court ruling in favor of Ames could provide a boost to the growing number of lawsuits by white and straight workers claiming they were discriminated against under company diversity, equity, and inclusion policies. Ames was in charge of ensuring the agency's compliance with a federal law designed to deter, let's just say, bad things from happening in prison. She has said that despite receiving positive feedback for her job performance, she was demoted to her old job in 2019 and had her pay cut by nearly $20 an hour. Ames has said she was replaced by a younger gay man, and that later in 2019 she was denied a promotion she had sought that went to a gay woman. She sued the department in 2020. As Ohio federal judge dismissed the case last year, saying she has not shown the background circumstances to support her discrimination claim. The Sixth Circuit upheld the decision last December. The Sixth Circuit said that background circumstances can include evidence that a member of a minority group, such as a gay person, made the challenged employment decision, or data showing a large pattern of discrimination by an employer against members of a majority group. So it's early October right now, and I can't find any sort of update on this case. And I found an article that says it's unclear when exactly the Supreme Court will hear arguments in Ames' case, although Supreme Court sessions typically last from October until late June or early July of the following year. So maybe they'll pick it up now that it's October again, but we shall see, probably with everything with the election. Don't really know if they're gonna dive into this case, but let me know what you think about this. It's one of those things where you hear a lot of times, I feel like injustice has been performed against me, but there's nothing I can do about it. At least this woman is trying to do something about it. Whether she wins or loses, at least she's giving it a shot. Talk to you later.